My name is Rachel Nish, and I'm one of the founders of Reincarnate. I just purchased a greenhouse beginning of last year. It's in Plymouth, Michigan. It's called Gray's Greenhouse.
I'm Chelsea. I'm one of the founders of Reincarnate. I'm also a florist, and my business is called Wildscape Floral Company.
Hi, my name is Annabelle Otto, and I'm here today with A Growing Business to give you a sneak peek for Reincarnate, a floral installation and living gallery in Ann Arbor, Michigan.
I really stumbled into this project completely. I met with a man named Noah Kaplan, who is kind of the visionary behind this whole block of buildings. And at the time, there was kind of an empty space in the back in this little house, and he didn't know what to do with it. And we started talking about just oddball, crazy ideas. Didn't come up with one really, but he said he wanted to do something to attract attention to the space. And he wanted to do it, you know, within the next 3 months or something crazy. And so just I own a greenhouse, so I'm in kind of the floral plant world. So that's kind of where my mind went. I also met with Danny Vinos, who's the owner of University Flower Shop, and kind of this idea of foraged goods and florists and play and just wild, totally immersive experience was born. And the first year really was a totally bizarre, immersive experience.
First year of Reincarnate, I don't really think I had a plan. We were so focused on like putting it together that I was like, I'm just gonna make a cool scene of some sort. But it turned out really cool, and it kind of got my brain thinking about what other things I could do, and just seeing what everyone came up with was really, really cool and inspiring. And there were things that I didn't really think were even possible that people did. And I still remember Danny's, she did a snake the first year, and I was like, oh my God, you can do that with flowers. Like, that was the coolest thing to me. And then last year, I did a nest. I really wanted people to be able to like come in and kind of feel supported, and like you could sit in it, and all these kids came and sat in it, and it was like really nice. And I just wanted it to feel like you were hugged by the outside, basically.
I mean, the first year I was, really both years, people have been, you know, they think it's pretty cool. There's nothing like this. What I think is really, really impressive is the response of the florists. I mean, these are people who are growing flowers or running a business, just kind of winding down their season right now, although fall now really, the season keeps going. And everyone is just willing to go to enormous lengths to do this crazy art thing for like crumbs of money.
I just hope that it continues to be like an outlet for creative people who are usually driven by, you know, clients' needs, desires, which is great, but we get to say, this is what I want to do, this is the idea I want to explore, I want to try this mechanic, just see how it goes. Like, it's the most amazing play space that a florist can have, and that is important to me, that, you know, florists get to have this creative outlet. We just want like florists to feel really valued and have this creative space.
It's just this time to play. You know, you go on a walk in the woods and you cut down a whole bunch of stuff, you know, throw it in your car, and you just get to play with things. And that has turned out to be enough of an incentive to give up a lot of their time and just make something really cool.
I think that we are really fortunate in Southeast Michigan that everyone here is very, very supportive. Like, I don't feel in competition, and I don't think that anyone really feels that way, because we all like freelance for each other, or we have a group chat where we're like, well, what do you think about this? Or can I borrow this from you? You know, it's very supportive and community-based, and this is like the one time a year we get to all come together and like make really cool stuff just for the sake of making cool stuff with our friends. Like, it's like floral homecoming or something. Like, it's so amazing to be able to spend time with your people who get it. That's, I think, part of the like community and part of the magic that this event has, is it really brings people together.
cool and fun thing. It's just, yeah, it's just fun. And it's fun with people who also think this is fun.
I think for this event specifically, it's great to throw all the design principles out the window. This is like the one place where you get to play by no one's rules and there's no downfall. There's no client that's gonna come and say, actually, those colors don't make sense together because it's your thing. But normally, I have learned actually a lot from Sue, who's here right now, and we try to think about like working with different color palettes and working in threes and working with different like design principles that I think people use for any medium. I think that can apply to floristry just as well as painting or photography or something like that. I kind of think that the more you learn, the less creative sometimes you can be. So I think it's good to know the rules, but also know how to break them really well. And this is one of the spaces where you can learn how to break rules and still make it look really awesome.
In the event business, everyone is used to working very fast to throw something together that's incredible. And so it's amazing how fast these things go up.
All of this stuff is pretty much already used, and so it can continue to be used. Like, it's not at the end of its life at all, which is the whole name. You know, we wanted it to be something that this is the end of the season and everything seems like it's dying, but how can we give everything a second life? And then we're like, okay, well, what do we call it? Reincarnate.
I think what's cool is like, it's a very arts for art's sake kind of thing. Because I become a total Scrooge at some point about this every year. I'm like, oh, I don't have time for this. And it's like, you know, why do you do this? Like, we're all running our own businesses, you know, but you do have to keep doing things that are just good because they're good. Like, it's, you know, it doesn't have a lot of connections, it doesn't have a real higher cause, it doesn't make a ton of money, but it's just cool. And there are things that you have to put in enough, like, you have to put in the effort just because you love it and it's beautiful. Then that's enough.
For more on A Growing Business, be sure to subscribe. We're here to help you find everything you need to know about starting a business that nourishes your community. We want to hear from you. If you run your own sustainable business, reach out on social media or our website.